Joey Badass. What's up, man?
Nice nitty. What's goody?
Hey, listen, I'm just glad you made some time. I know you're busy getting ready to album.
Oh, yeah. You know I had to make some time. You know I was going to come through. Show
okay,
love.
Good.
We've been trying to make this happen for a minute, actually.
I actually caught feelings because it didn't happen yet, and I was telling Ero.
Really?
Because Ero hit me up. He's like, yo, we got to make sure we support Joey. And I was like, yeah, I do, except.
He ain't come on my show yet.
Yeah, and I've been trying. But no, I know you're busy. You're getting ready.
And you know, it's less about being busy. It's also timing is everything.
It is.
With me now. And I think, you know, the timing couldn't be more better than
this
now.
Right now.
Yeah, yeah.
All American Badass. Interesting with the
April
KKKs.
April 7th.
That's a big day. Now, let's talk about this because you got the KKKs. I obviously know what this is all about.
Yeah.
Are you going to be addressing so many of our social issues right now?
Yes. Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I am so happy about this.
Yeah.
Okay, so now how did the collab with you and J. Cole happen?
Okay, you know, so the story with that is pretty interesting. Besides it being totally inevitable.
Right.
You know what I mean? Me and Cole, we've been building over the years, you know, just like by linking up and just, you know, just vibing, just talking and, you know, chilling. But recently, like, you know, last year in 2016 in the summertime, he hit me up to come to the studio and just hear something, you know. So I went over there to go check him out. And, you know, to make a long story short, he played me what was False Prophets.
Wow.
And, you know, he had me come to the studio basically to get my blessing on him using my beat for False Prophets. And the way it even came about is that, you know, he was at home just on YouTube, browsing on, you know, looking at beats. Like, you know, we usually, what us rappers usually do, you know, once I, you know, when we ain't really getting anything from our producers,
right,
you know, we resort back to, you know, the basics. So he came across that beat. He knew it was mine, but he was just vibing with it. And once he laid it down, you know, he kind of knew that he had to receive my blessing on it, you know, which he got, because, you know, I was just honored that he was even asking me for my blessing. You know, this is one of my favorite rappers, you know what I mean? So, yeah, it was definitely... I'm glad we made it happen, and through that process, you know, I got the feature. You know,
yeah,
what I mean? I was the only. He told me I was the only person on his feature list. You know what I'm saying? So, literally the day before the album came out, he sent
his first
back. Yeah.
No.
Yeah. So yeah, he a real nigga.
Yeah. I love this. Now let's talk about Land of the Free, because everybody's been talking about how powerful the song is. You know, was this something that you had in mind already, or was it when you heard the beat and you're just like, all right, now this is what it's about? Or have this feeling been stewing in you?
So first, you know, we made the beat in the studio one night, you know, because like the way I made this album is, this is the first time where I wasn't just rapping the beat, so excuse me. We made the production, you know, one night in the studio, me, my man 1900, and Kirk Knight. And, you know, we were just vibing, and, you know, as soon as we laid the beat down, the production down, I knew it was special right away, but I didn't write to it right in that moment because, you know, when I'm in the studio and I'm vibing, I usually just like to give things a vibe, you know, a flow. I knew for that one, like, I had to sit with it, digest it, and, like, really, because I knew I wanted to say something, like, you know, really big and really deep on that record. So one morning, I just woke up, and, you know, I went in my home studio. I put the beat on, and, like, it just flowed out of me. And, you know, the song is really inspired from, you know, a lot of lectures I've watched, a lot of you know, people that I'm influenced, inspired by, such as, you know, Marcus Garvey, because at the time I was reading Philosophy and Opinions of Marcus Garvey, and you know, there's that one quote that stood out to me, which was, what you do today that is worthwhile will inspire others to act at some future time. And, you know, that was pretty much like the basis of that whole record, you know, which inspired me to make that and, you know, everything, and to put everything that I was saying into that record.
Do you get concerned that you know, the feds are going to be on you. I, you know, the reason I bring this up, obviously, they've always had the hip hop police. Right?
Yeah, yeah.
Now, I had a chance to talk to YG, and I know when he had a song about Trump, F Trump, you know, it was real. Like, you know, they're watching. They feel a certain way. They're telling the labels this or that, you know. Does that cross your mind, or is it just more of validation of what you're talking about?
Both.
Yes.
You know, it definitely is. It crosses my mind because, you know, all the people that I study were on, you know,
The watch list,
you know, COINTELPRO, you know. Mm-hmm. So it definitely crosses my mind in that aspect, but I see it, you know what I mean, happening. And it's like, you know, my eyes are super open. So it's just like, you know, it is what it is. You got to kind of like expect that once you, you know, take the platform to say things that people don't often say. So, I mean, it is what it is. I know what I'm here on this earth for. So, you know, I'm just going to live out that, fulfill that. And, you know, nobody ain't going to stop me until, you know, they box me. And yeah.
And even then, it's about, like you said, what Marcus Garvey said, you know, it's about that inspiration for others. You never know who you're inspiring right now.
Exactly.
And, you know, you were on CNN, which is so crazy that we're talking about this. You're on CNN, like, yeah. Right? It's like, yeah. Whatever, you know, it's just so, whatever.
No, it's not just whatever.
You know what I'm saying? It's crazy.
Yeah, it's
like,
a big deal.
And you didn't hold back. You were honest. And I appreciate you. And I thank you for, you know, standing up for Colin Kaepernick and having his back. That means a lot to me.
Of course.
I wanted to thank you for that.
Because everything he's doing means a lot to me, you know.
And I, to see this unity right now, the inspiration, do you feel that the tides of the people waking up is going to happen? I feel like it's already happening, but we need more, right? Obviously, we need a lot more. But do you feel when people are watching you and Colin and Chance and everybody, really, that is saying something, do you feel we'll be okay?
Yeah, ultimately, you know, that's what it's all about. Right. You know, it ain't gonna happen tomorrow, but that's why we must do what we do today to make sure that it happens, you know, at some future time. And yeah, I definitely think there's hope for the future. You know, for me to say there's not any hope for the future, I'm too, like, my voice is too powerful for me to even speak that into the universe, into this interview that's gonna be, you know, watch for many, many years from now. You know what I mean? So it's like, yeah, there's definitely hope for the future, you know, because there's people like Colin, there's people like Chance, you know, there's people like myself. You know what I mean? So, yeah, 100%. That's why we here.
Does your family get worried for you? Where they're like,
They definitely don't bring their worries to me, to my attention. You know what I mean? Because the prayers are way heavier than the worries anyway.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying? So there's no need to put that extra, you know, burden on my shoulders. You know what I mean? Because that's all it is. Like, this is deeper than life. This is bigger than us. You know what I'm saying? Like, what I'm about is bigger than just my life. It's bigger than me just being, you know, a son, or me just being a cousin, a grandson. You know what I mean? It's about me, you know, tapping into my higher spirit, you know what I'm saying? So it's not really much you could do to, you know, try to stop that or discourage that. Yeah. So, you know, I'm sure they do get worried, but they'll never bring it to my attention.
How about coworkers, labels, other artists? Have they been like, hey, yo, watch out a little bit? You know what I'm saying? Like,
I mean, it's common knowledge at this point.
Right.
You know what I mean? Everybody knows how smart I am. Mm-hmm. So everybody already knows that I've weighed out the option and I've calculated my moves. I've calculated the things that I'm saying already. So it's not much you could tell me. I know. You know what I'm saying? But look how, you know, that I'm going about it. It's just, you know, it is what it is. It's like, shit, I tell myself be careful. Like, you know, mentally all the time. But it is what it is. Like, wow, just speaking for, like, what I think is right is dangerous. Like, you know what I mean? I can't really agree with that all the time. You know what I'm saying? I got to say what's on my chest. I got to keep it a buck with people. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
At least that's just the way I plan on doing this shit, you know? So,
you know, the first time I interviewed you was at South By. It was for MTV years ago. That was the first time. And you still have the same grounded feeling. Very grounded, level-headed, know what you're doing, going. And now to see this, I feel like these are the times. This is your calling, right? Because, you know, music is cyclical, especially based on what's happening in society, right? And so maybe before people knew you were dope, they were like, yeah. But it was more like, you know, people who were conscious with things. Yeah. And now it's more like even mainstream is like, oh, we need this. We need this. It's because it's really happening right now. Do you feel, I mean, I know you're ready for it, but are you happy? I mean, unfortunately, it's at the cost of society. But do you feel like, all right, now you know what I've been talking about?
Yes, definitely I do. And what I can say to that point of just, you know, being overall happy, like these last couple of weeks have been so eye opening and inspiring for me, because like I've been linking up with people who've just been almost like reintroducing, like, you know, perspectives that I wasn't looking at enough.
Yeah.
You know, and being happy, but not just being happy, but being content is one of them. Yeah. You know what I mean? So it's like, I already know the energy and the passion and, you know, just the truth that I put into my music. So it's like, I don't need people to validate that for me. You know what I mean? So and that comes from me being at a level where I just want to be content with everything I do. So if I already know what I'm putting into my work, it's like, I don't need to be wrapped up about what I'm finna get out or get back from it. It's like, you know what I mean? I'm just here to do this. You know what I mean? And yeah, that's what it is. It's like, don't worry to be, you know, there's a quote, I can't remember who said it, but it's basically like, don't strive for recognition, just be worthy of it. You know what I mean? It's something along those lines.
That.
But yeah.
Yeah, you can't live your life waiting for validation from people, because you'll always be miserable at that point. You
exactly.
Know what I mean? It's just, it's never.
It's like my happiness is determined.
Based on you?
Yeah, it's outside of me. Yeah. And it should never be that way.
Absolutely.
You know? So.
Now, a little while ago, I remember there was talks about you and Troy Ave. What happened with that situation? Is everything okay? We're good? Because I didn't really know, because I didn't hear it from you, and I did not hear it from him.
Well,
you know, I didn't think there was anything of
it. You know, that's something that happened last year. And I mean, on my side, like, I don't care about it anymore. Good. Like, you know, the issue that we had or whatever, like, he had a pretty rough year.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's like, hey, man, at this point, it's just like, I wish that man more blessings.
I love that. There's other things to tackle right now. You know,
it's bigger things to tackle. And it's like, especially with the shit that I'm coming out and I'm talking about, is like, you know, for me to sit here and, like, you know, still try to bash a fellow, like, you know, black brothers, like, yo, I ain't here for that. You know what I'm saying? If people got problems and, like, you know, they want to keep it that, then it will stay that.
Right.
But, you know, it's oppressed to me. You know what I mean? Like,
I love
It's whatever, honestly.
I love that the focus is on real issues that affect all of us.
Exactly.
It's bigger than us.
It has to be, though.
Yes.
It's like, once we all come to that point where we all realize that this shit is bigger than life, then that's when we graduate. We get to that next level. You know what I mean? Like, we can't, like, it's so crazy. It's like, I was on vacation for my birthday. And, like, you know, I was just out there with like, you know, all my homies and everything, like my day ones. And we just on the beach, just smoking, catching a vibe, drinking, just playing, energy. And it's like, for some reason, I just thought, like, because we're sitting under the stars and there was like a million stars, like very clear in the sky, shit that I never get to see. And I was just thinking, like, yo, like, we're so small.
Really are.
Like, we're so small. Like, people got to learn how to take themselves outside of their bodies and look at the world from outside of you. You know what I mean? And you really start to understand, like, how bigger than life, you know, shit really is.
Yes, it's not about you.
Exactly.
If more people were selfless in that way.
I wish I could say that better, but it's like.
You will.
Yeah,
you will.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
It's getting there, because I know what you mean. And it's just like, that is why we are where we are as far as the state of the world. Not just here. Look at the world.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, there's real.
People are just so consumed in themselves. It's like, I've traveled outside of my body went like 10,000 feet in the air and then looked down at to where I was standing. It was like, wow. And that sounds crazy, but it's like, if you really try to visualize that shit, like imagine if you could look at yourself from being in the air.
It's amazing.
You know what I'm saying? And then just look like and see how small you are on that beach. Like, what I'm saying is like some Kanye shit. But.
I love it. but that's important because maybe that's the visual that people need instead of saying, hey, be selfless. Hey, worry about the world. Because when you hear that, you're kind of like, well, what can I bring to the world? But when you try to picture yourself, what are you bringing to this world?
Word.
You know what I mean? And I think it's so refreshing to see this.
Everybody has something to offer to the world.
Yes.
Everybody. You know what I mean? And it's important that everybody understands that.
Absolutely.
And knows that and believes in that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It, you know what? It was so interesting. Not that long ago, obviously, I saw the headlines of you saying that you were better than Tupac or whatever. And I know this doesn't sound bad, but I didn't want to click on it because I felt like, you know what? I don't want this. I don't want that to influence how I feel or look at you.
Right.
Know, what made you want to bring up, or how would I say this? What made you say that?
So, you know, one, what people looked at it as was like, I just came out and said that.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
That never
happened.
That's
why happened. I didn't want
to. You know what I mean? I never just was like, yo, put the camera on. Yo, I'm saying?
I'm better than,
That never happened. What really happened is I was doing an interview with Genius.
Yeah.
And, you know, just like how I'm doing an interview with Hot 97, but it's Ness Nitty.
Yeah.
I was with Rob Markman. So, you know, there's a level of comfort here.
Absolutely.
Like, just the way I just gave you that analogy about looking outside of myself. I've never said that to anybody in any interview. Yeah. So, you know, it's easy to forget that these cameras are here.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Especially when you have a relationship, right?
Exactly. So, you know, it's strong ways that I feel. And there's certain things I will say to you off camera that I wouldn't say when the cameras is rolling or if I'm, you know, conscious of the cameras rolling and shit. So, you know, there's that point. But just to the point of, you know, the people that don't know me, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Never heard Joey Badass music. I understand where they're coming from.
Right.
It's like, who the fuck are you? Like, what? Like, Tupac? Like, what? The greatest of all time?
Yeah.
And my favorite of all time, too. It's like, yo, so I can understand how, you know, people looked at this shit. But it's like, yeah, I stand behind what I said. Because, you know, once you really do get into Joey Badass music, you do listen to his mixtapes, you see that there was truth behind the statement.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, it is what it is. Like, I ain't trying to disrespect the great. You know what I mean? Like, Tupac is my favorite. Like, person, you know what I'm saying? In life. And it's like, you know, there's even a fucking Tupac interview or some shit where he's like, I'm better than Rakim. Like, you know what I'm saying?
You're supposed to compete.
You're supposed to feel like you better. But, you know, it's real facts, though.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, it's like what I was really explaining in the interview with Rob Markman that I've been wanting to touch on again is that what I was trying to explain to him is that once you have a generation come and do its work, the generation after that has the opportunity to be better because you've just set the bar.
Right.
And you set the bar before I was born. So now I'm born and it's like, oh, that's where it was at? Bet.
You have to work hard.
The shit that you did, the shit that like Jay-Z did at 22 is not what I'm doing at 22.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I have the opportunity to be better than Jay too.
Yeah.
It's like, that's what I'm trying to get people to realize. It's like, I don't want to just be the only one that feel this way and feel crazy. I need everybody to feel this way.
Right.
It's like, we are the future.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? We are the youth. We are the next generation.
Yeah.
Like Chance is going to be one of the biggest of all. He's going to be like on another level of rap when it's all said and done, because the way he's killing it now at the level that he's at, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So this is what I mean, like, you know, when I say shit like that, it's like, we gotta feel this way about ourselves. But you know, it ain't no disrespect to old people who ain't hear Joey Badass music out, new album coming, you know what I'm saying, April 7th,
and give it a chance. And here's the thing, like, for me, like, I understand competition, and as an artist, as a, you know, you want to be the greatest. You know what I mean? I think people forget that it's okay to want to be better than your idols. It's all right to feel that way.
Yeah, because it's like, we live in a generation where it's like, especially when it comes to the hip-hop music, people
sensitive.
Are settling way below the bar. Way below the bar. Like, the shit that niggas is accepting in rap is what's fucking everybody's perception up. You know what I'm saying?
Talk that talk.
Yeah, I mean, it is what it is. Don't get me wrong. Like, you know, with the shit that's a obvious contrast to the music that I make, I still enjoy that shit sometimes, because the music that I make, the shit that I put in my music, I think of every fucking minute of the day.
Right.
So sometimes a Lil Uzi song is a fucking escape for me. Absolutely. And people like me. So there needs to be a balance. I ain't saying that shit don't gotta be here. It right. just need to be a balance. You know what I'm saying?
And we need the balance.
Word.
That's the most beautiful part about hip hop, is that we've brought so many different elements to just the whole culture, right? So I love that you talked about that. And you know what? Everyone's entitled to their own opinion, but that's why you have to give it a chance to listen to your music, because someone who's younger, who might not really understand or could embody Pac, might be like, hey, look, this is how I feel about Joey. You know what I mean? Myself.
And look, I'm going to be critical. Back on that point, though, to all the people who thought I was crazy when I said that, but then they said that they was better than me, guess what? Then you're better than Pac too, fucking dummy.
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck? Like, right. And you should feel that way as well.
Right, and
like,
you should achieve for that. You
exactly.
Know?
Real talk.
I'm going to be a little harder on you. I don't know if I feel that way yet, but this is me being...
And that's good.
I'm entitled to that.
And you see that? That makes me go harder.
Exactly.
That makes me go
harder.
I want to see that. You know what I'm saying? Even though I already know what I'm doing and how much triple entendres I drop per song and shit like that. But it's like the fact that Ness Nitty doesn't know that and feel 100% is going to give me an extra boost.
Yes.
So thank you for keeping it a buck
with me.
You know what I mean?
And we have to with each other. We have to because there's the only way we can become great, become good, is that, look, I want to see that. I want to see, especially for the younger generation, right? They need that. There is nobody who's like, hey, I'm this confidence.
But you know, I was talking about bars, though, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Wow.
But still,
I'm being slept on.
Listen, no, I don't think you're slept on, but I appreciate everything you do, and I want to see that. I need a little bit more, but that's just me because I'm a fan of.
That's cool. I love that.
You're not the only one.
You know
but
what I mean?
I'll always
you and
tell
everybody
you.
Else yes. out there who feel that way inspire me to
and
go
And I'll be the
harder.
First one
Thank
the minute
you.
It happens and be like, word. Thank
Word.
You. You know, but you want the people who co-sign to believe in that, because that's when it's most genuine and authentic, you know, and that's the beautiful part about what you do, is that, again, you don't need validation for how you feel. And
exactly.
honestly, not to hate on myself, it doesn't matter what I think. It's all about what you do.
No, exactly.
You know
no,
what
word.
I'm saying?
That's what I said. Like, you know, I know how I feel.
That's all that
but
matters.
But the fact that I know that you and a lot of people out there
right.
don't see eye to eye with me in that time yet, you know what I'm saying, is
right.
going to just make me go harder and make more music,
yep.
you know, and just be more content with myself.
It's beautiful. We need this.
Yeah.
We're tired of, oh, yeah, it's okay. It's great. It's good. We don't want good. We don't want average work anymore. We want great. And I just love your passion. I love this. You have no idea how exciting this is. Maybe because I see so many artists and they just don't have that passion in their eye, that drive, that yo, what?
Right. Yeah, thank you.
Don't change. Don't get Hollywood on me and be
look,
like, hey, listen.
Well, you know what's funny? You know it's something I want to touch on too, is like, I don't know if I'm so grounded and so humble that every time I come around, it seems like it's my first time again. You know
yes.
what I'm saying? I've been in the game for 5 years.
Yeah.
I ain't changed yet.
No.
I'm not changing. You know what I mean? Yeah. Ain't gonna be no change. I'm gonna be like this forever.
Listen, I appreciate you, man. And the fact that it's not that you're just a good spirit, you're very talented. And it's hard to come across artists who are genuine, authentic, and really are about this. And on top of it, you're good at acting.
Thank you.
Not to bring a pocket game, but you know, he was great at acting.
Yeah.
So there's, you know, signs of
and
excitement,
you know,
man.
And said, even to that point, like, I aspire to, like, you know, continue to do what Pac couldn't do because he got cut short. You know what I'm saying? Like, I aspire to do that. Like, you know, to be as great in both. But, you know, not just because it's Pac, because that's something that I genuinely love to do. Yeah. But, you know, because he's one of my favorite people and happen to do the same thing, I'm like, you know, I wanna do more than he did.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Just to keep it running, to inspire the next generation. Like, yo, I want to do more than what Joey did.
And if you're not feeling like that, that's a problem, in my opinion.
Super problem.
But that's my opinion, right?
People don't know their end goals nowadays, man. They don't see the end. They don't see longevity. They just see the now. And you know what I mean? We live in a world of instant gratification.
Oh,
you just want it now. And it's
now,
like
now,
people
now.
Don't understand, like, this is about the future.
Yes. Did you like acting?
I love acting.
Now,
I went to high school for acting.
Okay, so now if you had to pick and it came down to it between music and acting, what would it be?
Oh, I mean, music is my bread and butter. Music is number one.
But that check is nicer, right, for acting?
No.
Really?
Nah. The same way you come in music and you a young gun, you come in acting and you a young gun, and you get that young gun bag and that young gun check. Uh-oh. You know what I'm saying? I mean, not saying, like, you know, they ain't pay me, but it's like they ain't pay me nothing close to what I make on music.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The shit that they paid me compared to what I make on music felt like nothing.
Yeah.
It felt like, okay, Ma, go cash that check. It's yours.
That's so nice.
You know what I'm saying? Like, type shit. I'm just
saying. This is so hilarious. But listen, as you get the money, from what I've heard, I don't know, because I don't rap and I don't act. But I heard that acting money is, you know, nice.
I'm sure.
When you're
When you get at that, you know, I got to just do a couple more movies.
You know?
You know, maybe one or two more series, and then maybe I'll be at that nice big bag.
Yeah.
But right now, yeah, music my bread and butter. Now, music keeping the lights on.
Yeah, for sure. Now, you said that you went to the Grammys because, you know, you wanted to see Chance win.
Right.
How was that feeling?
I gotta say, I also went to the Grammys because, you know, to prepare myself for next year. But, you know, with Chance, it's crazy because I had a dream like 3-4 years ago. And I told him too, like, where me and him was both at the Grammys. And it was, we did a song way back in the day. And for whatever reason, we won a Grammy for the song that we did. But I know it wasn't, you know, I know it wasn't the song that we did a long time ago. I just knew it was a vision, like some type of foreshadowing. So, like, just for it to come back full circle and me be there to witness that moment, because me and Chance go way back, you know what I'm saying? Like, he was at my first show when I came to Chicago. You know what I mean? On my tour bus, we smoking. I told him, like, yo, bro, you got to smoke them cigarettes off the bus, bro. Like, you know what I mean? We go way back.
Yeah.
Like, so it was just very inspiring. It made me, like, you know, very happy, because me and Chance, as far as this independent shit go, we play the same game. You know what I'm saying? So his success is my success. My success is his success. Yep. And I love seeing that.
It's all of our success, really.
Oh yeah, exactly.
It's,
you know,
of
all of our success, really. And yeah, it was so inspiring. You know, I wanted to see him take home everyone he was nominated for. Everyone. I mean, I felt that Q had the best rap album.
Yeah.
But you know, I wanted to go to either one of my niggas.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Chance and Q was my niggas. Like, I wanted it to go to either one of them. It's a win. But yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm happy for, you know, that whole situation. Happy for my brother Chance. And yeah, you know, next year, you're going to see me out there.
Yay, man. Yeah. Listen, I'm so happy for you. I know you got added to the lineup, Lollapalooza.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Are you excited for this?
Oh, yeah. I've always wanted to do Lollapalooza. So I'm just ready to give, like, you know, the same way everybody think it's a new Joey in the music, it's a new Joey every time you come and see me perform. Mm. So I'm just ready to hit that stage again and give you me in this new form. You know what I'm saying?
I love this, man. You're just going to leave your soul out there. This
exactly.
I know, because I just know the energy you have, and even just a conversation with you. I'm excited for the album April 7th because we need this music. It's not just, oh, it's going to be nice. No, we need it. Even if you're unfamiliar with Joey Badass, this is the time you want to get involved. This is the time you want
exactly.
to listen. And, you know, I always have compassion for people because, like you said, instant gratification. There's so much distraction out there.
Right.
But this, during these times, this is good for your soul. You know what I mean?
Indeed.
And it's something that we all need, not just me or whoever. We all need this as a community. And I'm really excited to see where your journey goes.
Thank you.
You know what
Appreciate
I mean?
Appreciate you. Nice.
Listen, I'm hyped for you. Anytime you want to come through and hang out with us, don't forget about us. Listen, when you start making all extra Hollywood check money, you know what I'm saying?
Look, I think I'm really going to be like the only rapper that, like, when I get super big, I'm still going to be coming back and killing radio freestyle.
I love this. Thank you.
I'm still going to be coming back and having these. You might be in my, like, palace and shit, but it's all good. We still going to do the interview.
We're going to have a conversation.
Yeah, exactly.
But it's so important that you still care to talk to the people, the regular average person who's watching this, who might not have enough money to go to your show, but watches this and is like, you know what, I'm gonna put money aside, I want to go see him, he's inspiring me. Because people forget that, you know, there's a lot of people struggling,
yeah,
and the fact that you make music for people to relate to no matter what class they're in. Yeah. You know, it's rare nowadays. Sometimes we can't relate to the Versace and the Gucci and the bling. It's like,
want
to
relate.
You want to? Like, we all want to have that great life, but sometimes we just need that for the soul, and, you know, you provide that.
Yeah.
So I'm very thankful for you, man.
Thank you.
Don't forget about us.
Oh, never. Thankful for this interview,
too. Of course. Thank you so much.
No problem.